I hear soy can help with my hot flashes.
I hear soy is gonna give my son breasts.
Oh, soy, you controversial little bean. Here's the deal. In my opinion, although everyone's a little different, a little bit of soy is okay for most people. Soy is actually a great source of protein and has been shown to have some anti-cancer properties. However, it's all about the source and it's all about the form that it comes in. What do I mean? Well, listen, I like to recommend soy in its least processed form. This is things like tempeh, which is a fermented soybean patty, delicious. Miso, which is fermented soybean paste, also delicious and very easy to digest. Tofu, often sprouted, is an easy way to digest it. And edamame, which is in its least processed form, just as a soybean pod. I usually tell people to stay away from the soy protein isolates and concentrates that are found in those protein bars and protein powders. This is a very, very highly processed and not well-absorbed form of soy protein. Plus, it's almost always guaranteed to be genetically modified, which brings me to my next point. No genetic modification. If you eat soy, buy organic. Over 90% of the soy that we're eating in our diet right now is genetically modified, which is a whole other episode, but it usually means that it's been tampered with. And I don't like to see nature tampered with. Eat it in its pure, whole form. Keep away from the soy sausage, the soy patties, the soy ice cream, the soy milk, the soy creams, the soy yogurts, the soy this, the soy that. Stick with it in its most pure form. That's where you get the benefits of soy. Soybean eyebrow shaper, the soybean nose clipper, the soy...